forget, water makes you healthy, gives you a glowing skin, helps you mind your business too. So drink water. We're going to be drinking a lot of water for this section, okay? Guys, tell me, where else do you want to be this year? Don't you want to be with the energy goddess? Back to my channel. My name is Natasha Essie and I am so glad to have you all here. This is my first video for the year, so happy new year. If you are new to this video, please make sure you are subscribed to my channel and also make sure you like this video, share, comment down below. Let's get so much time. So today's video, we're going to be talking about anxiety coping skills, and also I will be giving up affirmation tips to help you cope during this time. So I have some things jotted down here. Most times when I try to put things together like this, I make sure that I write before I come out here to speak about it. So right here I have some of this jotted down right here, and I will be looking like up and down, so I hope you guys, I hope you all don't mind. What was I trying to say? Anxiety, a feeling of worry, nervousness, uneasy about something with uncertain outcome. Another word for anxiety is a strong desire, a concern to do something, for something to happen. Similar word for anxiety is worry. You need to understand that anxiety really doesn't come with gender. You don't have to be a male or a female to go through anxiety. Anxiety could strike on anybody. I mean, a female can go through anxiety. Everyone probably goes through an anxiety period. So yeah, that's why I'm here today, to give you the coping skills just in case you fall into the victim of one. All right, let's do it. Step one, I breathe a lot. Breathe, just breathe, keep breathing. Just keep breathing, no matter what happens. Just get into a comfortable position. Close your eyes and breathe. Breathe through your mouth and your nose. Imagine breathing in a calming color such as blue. Blue is really a calming color. I think I have some touch of blue here. So yeah, it's okay. You can just look at me and breathe. How about the right? Blue is peaceful. Blue is calming. Blue is gentle. It has tremendous powers to manage stress. Yeah, blue. Blue is a very calming color, and trust me, it helps. Because most times, you just go through that whole crazy stress and crazy stress period, and all you need to do is to just be in a position and think of the colors that calms you down. You might not know this as a person if you don't know how to handle your anxiety yet, but I'm telling you that blue is awesome. Blue is amazing. Blue is like the first color I can talk about whenever it comes to stress relief. Another thing is for you to exhale through your mouth. Exhale through your mouth. Breathe out. That's what it means. Breathe out. Exhale through your mouth. And imagine your anxiety leaving your body. And think about a color like red. Red. Red is awesome. Red is something that melts. It's I don't know, but red for me, red just, it doesn't, I wouldn't say it calms you down, because blue calms you down, but red puts you on that track. Red says to you like, girl, I don't have time, I'm ready to leave now. So yeah, I love red. So think of a color like red. Anxiety coping skills two, go outside. If you're going through an anxiety, make sure you step out as much as you can. You might not want to, your body might tell you not to, but each time your body tells you not to step out, please make sure you imagine stepping outside during anxiety. Your body says, no, I don't want to go. But then you are saying, yes, I want to go. your body keeps fighting. As much as it tells you not to go outside, please make sure you are stepping outside and you're not just going there to stand out or look out or something else. You are going out there to feel the warmth or the coolness. Also look at the clouds. The stars are also very, very helpful. So yeah, the stars and the clouds helps you during your anxiety period. So much air, you need so much air to just wave through your hair area, just pass through your ears. All this put together helps so much with anxiety. So let's do the top three. Grounding. Most times our bodies really want to go into transit, but a lot of us gives it a waiver. Describe in 3 to 5 words how you feel. Keep going in details, keep doing it. Don't leave, don't let your body get out of it. Don't even let your body leave. Make sure you go into details of the things you can see around you. It also helps you a lot during your anxiety, and this is a coping skill that would help you a lot. Try it today. Sounds tribal. Of course it sounds tribal. Like, who wants to go, or who's going through an anxiety that just wants to run into the bathroom and go take a shower? Who goes through a heartbreak that wants to take a shower? Definitely everybody just feels like, okay, yeah, I don't feel too good right now, so yeah, I can always stay and I'll take a shower. That doesn't work, darlings. No, it doesn't work. Trust me, you need to take a shower. I'm going to read it from here. So shower. If you're able to take a shower, this might sound trivial, like I said before, but it's one of my favorite ways to come out of anxiety. Just trust me on this one. Trust me. I know I love the fact that I get into the shower like 4 times a day, 3 to 4 times a day, but yeah, it's far from it. Showers helps during taking a shower, taking a warm bath or taking a cold bath helps your anxiety disappear. It just relieves you. Imagine turning on the shower and just going in with your whole body, your head, or imagine having some warm water in a bathtub where you have to like soak your whole body, but don't stay in there for a long time so you don't begin to ponder. But if you know you're a strong person and you can hold things down, I really recommend a bathtub. I love to be in tubs because I can always burn some candles alongside essential oils that also helps during this period. But yeah, taking a shower is really a great way to get out of anxiety quickly. It's the biggest skill. Trust me. My biggest top five for an anxiety coping skill is, can you take a guess? I bet you can't. Essential oils. I love essential oils. Essential oils are a huge part of my anxiety coping skills. And my personal favorite essential oils are lavender, chamomile oil, frankincense oil, sweet orange, jasmine, and I think it's called Better Wolf or something. I don't know. I'm going to check it out again. And I'll leave the name down below. I'm going to leave the names of all the essential oils I just mentioned down below my description box. With you, maybe 5, 6, 7, or maybe 10 affirmation tips. The following things and repeat out loud. Repeat it over and over and over again. Repeat it as much as you can. Don't stop, just keep saying it to yourself. I'm going to be sharing with you a few affirmation tips you can always use when you are going through an anxiety period. I am not in danger, I am fine. A panic attack cannot hurt me. I am beginning to calm down. I am breathing enough air. I am in charge of how I feel. Thoughts are not always true. I am happy to be who I am, where I am, and when I am. I love and forgive myself. I am enough. I can always get all I want. I need more because I am worth more. I love me. Thank you for watching my anxiety coping skill video alongside my affirmation tips I just shared. I hope someone finds this helpful. I just need you to know that whatever anxiety you're going through right now, you can always shake it out. Shake it out of your body. You are enough. You don't even need more because you are enough. Look at yourself and look around you and tell yourself that you are enough. I hope someone finds this video helpful. Please make sure you share this video to save a sister, to save a brother, to save anyone around you if you really know you love these people. To my subscribers, thank you all for showing this love. Thank you for showing your support. Thank you for always watching and viewing my videos. I really do appreciate you and I love you. And let's do this again and again and again. Bye, guys.